We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
See, according to convolution integral, we can solve the example based on the convolution integral. So I have write the formula in the whiteboard. Basic formula I have write, which is known as y of t, which is equal to integration minus infinite to plus infinite x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. There it is known as d tau. So it is the equation of convolution integral. It is the equation of convolution integral convolution integral. Based on the convolution integral, we can write determine the convolution of two signal x1 of t and x2 of t. X1 of t equal to e raised to minus 4t u of t, and x2 of t equal to u of t minus 4. Now we have solved the example based on that. So apply the definition of convolution integral. Y of t equal to minus infinite to infinite integration x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So x1 of tau equal to e raised to minus 4 tau u of tau, x2 of t minus tau equal to u of t minus tau minus 4. So now we can put e raised to minus 4 tau u of tau into u of t minus tau minus 4 d tau. So here we can put u of minus tau. See this here, tau is the main variable. I have write here, tau is the main variable. Tau equal to can be considered as a main variable. So here minus tau plus t minus 4. So here we can put, see this, minus sign considered as a common. So here we can take consider as a mere operation. So mere and delay. What is the delay? T minus 4, it is indicated by delay. And u of tau equal to unit step signal. See this. Unit step and here mere and delay. So now if you can multiply with this, see this. So real answer is 0 to T by 4. See this. 0 to T by 4. E raised to minus tau d tau 0 to minus 4 e raised to minus 4 tau d tau. तो टी रेस टू माइनस फोर ब्रेकेट में टी माइनस फोर डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस फोर माइनस टी रेस टू जीरो डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस फोर सो वन अपॉन फोर माइनस टी रेस टू माइनस फोर टी टी रेस टू सिक्सटीन डिवाइडेड बाय फोर विच इज नोन एज y ऑफ t विच इज नोन एज y ऑफ t y ऑफ t इज द आंसर सी दिस दिस इज द आंसर फाइनल आंसर ऑफ एग्जाम्पल वन Here we have discussed the example 1 for today's lecture. Now next example, find the convolution of two signals, x1 of t and x2 of t, where x1 of t equal to u of t and x2 of t equal to u of t minus 4. So apply the definition of convolution integral. See this, this is the answer. Apply the definition of convolution integral. So we can highlight y of t equal to x of tau into h of t minus tau with respect to integration minus infinite to plus infinite. So here x1 of tau into x2 of t minus tau d tau. So here u of tau into u of t minus tau minus 4. So here we can say that it is u of tau into u of t minus tau minus 4. Now sketch the graph of individual function. See this, this is u of tau. See this, this is u of tau and this is u of t minus tau minus 4. So here we can do the multiplication and we can get the answer from 0 to 4. And we can get the answer from 0 to t minus 4, sorry. Why? Because t minus 4 can be considered as a delay. See this delay. So 0 to t minus 4, 1. So answer is t minus 4. This is the correct answer. See this. This is the correct answer. Now, so t minus 4, it is the correct answer. Now, so this is the second example that can be completed. See this, this is the second example of today's lecture. Now see third example. Determine the convolution of the two signal x1 of t and x2 of t, where x1 of t equal to e raised to minus 4t u of t and x2 of t equal to u of t plus 4. So apply the definition of convolution integral. So we can get y of t equal to minus infinite to infinite integration x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So x1 of tau equal to e raised to minus 4 tau u of tau and x2 of t minus tau equal to u of t plus 4 minus tau into d tau. So here e raised to minus 4 tau into u of tau into u of minus tau plus t plus 4. So minus bracket tau minus t minus 4. So first of all apply the mirror operation. Then we can apply the delay operation. So here we can get the delay of t plus 4. Why? Because see this, here minus sign can be considered as a common. So minus bracket mass t plus 4 and here mirror operation can be applied. So here mirror and delay operation that can be present. So here we can say that see, this is u of tau. Here u of minus tau, first applied the mirror operation u of tau, that's why it is known as mirror operation. And mirror plus advance operation, that can be get here easily. So here 0 to t plus 4. So 0 to t plus 4, e raised to minus 4 tau, u of tau into u of minus bracket ma tau minus bracket ma t plus 4. See this very carefully. And what is the multiplication of that? Multiplication of that is equal to 1. That's why e raised to minus 4 tau into 1 into d tau. Here e raised to minus 4t plus 4. E raised to minus 4t into e raised to minus 16 minus 1. It is the answer. See this. This is the answer. This is the last answer of this third example. See this. This is the third example of that particular lecture. Now see this next example. Find the convolution of two signals x1 of t equal to e raised to minus 4t u of t, and x2 of t equal to u of t plus 1. So this is the, compared to previous example, it is same, only limit change, which is known as 0 to t plus 1. Simply saying Gujarati language, or simply saying simple language, put t equal to 0, whatever term that can be present inside, put equal to 0. That means what? Put here t equal to 0, t equal to 0, t equal to t plus 1 equal to t minus tau. T minus tau plus 1 equal to 0. So here we can get the limit tau equal to t plus 1. Tau equal to, we can get t plus 1. So here we can get limit tau equal to t plus 1, 0 to t plus 1. We can do the integration from 0 to t plus 1, and we can get the answer related to that. Now, determine the convolution of two signals, x1 of t and x2 of t, where x1 of t equal to e raised to minus 4t u of t, and x2 of t equal to u of minus t plus 1. So here, e raised to minus 4 tau u of tau, and x2 of u of minus bracket ma t minus tau plus 1. So here, u of minus t, see here, minus bracket ma common, u of minus bracket ma t minus tau plus 1. So minus t plus tau plus 1 into d tau, e raised to minus 4 tau u of tau. So here we can get tau common, u of tau bracket ma tau minus bracket ma t minus 1 d tau. So here, u of tau into u of tau minus t minus 1. Here we can get limit from t minus 1 to infinite. It is the limit. So if you can solve this integration, e raised to minus 4 tau upon minus 4. So t minus 1 to infinite, e raised to minus infinite equal to 0. So here answer is this. And if we can put t equal to 0, so then put here t equal to 0, then answer is this. So it is the correct answer. It is the correct answer. And if t less than 0, t less than 0 means what? Put any particular value of t. So we can get the answer 0 to infinite for t less than 0. Sorry, t greater than 0. T greater than 0 here, 0 to infinite. So here answer is 1 by 4. So it is the correct answer related to that particular integration. So it is known as the correct answer for different values. So it is the fourth example related to convolution integral. How to solve the convolution integral? Simply we can identify, I have write here x of t convolution with h of t equal to, it is known as convolution integral. It is known as convolution integral. Now see, determine the convolution integral for two given signal, x1 of t and x2 of t, where x1 of t equal to e raised to minus 4t u of t, and x2 of t equal to u of minus t. So this is the other, another example. So applied that convolution definition of convolution integral. So here we can get e raised to minus 4 tau u of tau, and here u of minus bracket ma t minus tau. So here tau minus t. So here e raised to minus 4 tau into u of tau minus t d tau. So u of tau into u of tau minus t, which is equal to 1, obviously, and limit t to infinite. So here e raised to minus 4t divided by 4, and limit for t less than 0. If t less than 0, so 0 to infinite, answer is 1. So 0 to infinite, answer is 1 by 4. So So it is the correct answer related to this particular convolution integral. So it is the basic example related to convolution integral. Up till now, whatever we have discussed this example, based on that, in final exam, example will be asked. How to sketch the graph? It is comparatively very, very easy. Put here u of tau, which is equal to 1. U of tau minus t means what? Applied the delay. And now if you can multiply with this, see this, if you can do multiplication with this, then answer here we can get starting from t up to infinite, we can get the answer. So it is the final answer from t to infinite. See this, the limit. See, that is the limit for t to infinite. See this. So it is the final answer. Ideally, if you can write this particular answer, then there is no problem. Neglect whatever cases. That is not required for the final exam. Final exam, it is just required this answer. So be carefully prepared this. And if you can put here t equal to 0, see this. Then e raised to 0 equal to 1. So at t equal to 0, answer is 1 by 4. See this. At t equal to 0, answer is 1 by 4. See this very carefully. This is the different method. I will discuss in the next lecture. See this. T equal to 0, answer is 1 by 4. And remaining answer, e raised to minus 4t divided by 4. So it is the last answer. So be carefully prepared. Convolution integral one of the method which is known as equation method. Now second method is convolution integral by first method, which is known as equation method. Second, which is known as graphical method. So it is the two different method, which is known as convolution method, convolution integral method. Convolution integral method by equation method and graphical method. Equation method completed in this lecture. And graphical method will be discussing next lecture. So it is the topic related for particular lecture. Thank you. Convolution in time domain. What is the application of convolution that I have mentioned here? Convolution in time domain, remember that word, convolution in time domain is equal to multiplication of two signals, convolution in time domain of two different signals is equal to multiplication of two signals. Multiplication of that signal in frequency domain. See this? This is the application of convolution. So this is the last topic that can be pending for that particular lecture. In next lecture, we have discussed the graphical method of convolution. Thank you.